Hello, and welcome to learning about the elements of art. We have six elements of art. They are line, shape, texture, which we'll look at today, and tomorrow we will do space, color, and value. The first one is line. Line can be defined by a path that is made by a moving point. Now, those who take geometry are probably going to have line is the shortest distance between two points, but in art, we can make our line as long and as curvy as we want. It can vary in length, width, direction, curvature, value, which means it goes maybe from really dark to really light and back to dark again, and color. The types of lines are horizontal, vertical, diagonal, curved, and zigzag. What kind of lines are shown in this photo by Kayla Kuhn? Do you notice that the shadows cast light and dark shadows on the wide boards? So that would be a change in value for the wide board line. What types of lines are shown in this photo by Destiny Coronado? We can see curved lines from the edge of the shoe. We can see zigzag lines from the tread at the front of the shoe. We can actually see dashed lines in the stitching. Are there lines in the water? Of course there are. Even though they are really different in shape, some very short, some very long, the difference in value between the highlights of the water and the shadow of the water really create different kinds of lines. And don't forget the grass in the back. We have all sorts of diagonal lines in the back. Discrete and implied lines. These are two types of lines that you guys will have to go out and photograph. The implied lines you can see, but you cannot touch. And discrete lines are lines that you can touch. You can actually physically hold them. In this particular photograph, you can see that there are discrete implied lines. If you look at the gentleman with the tattoo, the tattoos, now that they are old, are very smooth. If you were to touch them, you couldn't actually like grab hold of the tattoos, but you see them. And so the implied lines of the color between the skin and the tattoo is an implied line. Via the snake is actually a discrete line. He's actually being able to touch the snake. The snake is the discrete line. And so therefore the difference would be the tattoos you can't touch, and so they're implied lines, versus the snake, which is real, and so that is a discrete line.
Once you take your line and you start to create it and connect that line to some other point within it, you end up with a shape. Shape really is an area that's enclosed by a line. So shapes can be organic or geometric. Geometric shapes you will typically find in math class. Perfect squares, rectangles, parallelograms, triangles, circles. Specific shapes like that are considered geometric. You can find organic shapes in your science class. When you look through the microscope at an amoeba, you'll notice that its shape is certainly not like one you'd find in math class. It's a very organic shape that has rounded edges and moves around. Now, two dimensions definitely is a shape. When we look at an object in a photograph, because that photograph has already flattened it, once it's in a photograph, it will always be considered a shape. In real life, though, those objects may be three-dimensional. Similar to your ceramics class, where you're looking at a vase, if you look at it in real life, it's going to be a form. Once it's a photograph, then it may end up as just a shape. In this photo by Ashley, think about whether it's organic or geometric. I see it as being organic because the shapes within the pine cone are not perfect shapes that we would find in math class. They have jagged edges and rough trims. In this photo by Elliot, we see it as definitely being geometric. The shapes are squares or diamonds, depending on how you look at it. But it could be argued that it is organic because the way the plastic has melted over the metal, it has left little droplets at the bottom. those droplets create a different sort of shape in those diamonds. So it makes those diamonds kind of an irregular or more organic shape.
Texture. Texture is how an object looks or feels. Feel your elbow. What does it feel like? Does it feel like your sweater or your Letterman jacket? Or does it feel rough because you forgot to put lotion on this morning? What does your elbow feel like? Real texture can be felt, hence your elbow. We can feel it. Implied texture is created by the changes in the surface of an object, like when we take a photograph. Now, when we take photographs, all of our texture would be considered implied. But if you actually feel a photograph, there is some real texture there. We can have a glossy finish to our photograph. We can have a matte finish to our photograph. And those are things that we will take into consideration, but not at this time. So we're going to assume that all of our implied texture is in our photographs. And we're taking photographs of real texture that become implied texture. How many different kinds of texture can you see in this photo by Elena? You can see the smoothness of the leaves. You can see the soft, curvy shapes of the camellia petals. You can see the satin finish on the headband. You can see the fuzziness of the fur coat. You can see the smooth tip of her little tiny pink Converse tennis shoes. You can see the rough bark that she's standing on. In addition to that, she has applied an additional Photoshop filter to give even more texture to this photograph.